10 degrees, so it's nice out. But there's a chance of rain, so I'm not really going to do anything outside. I just noticed after all this time that the back of this small bulkhead wasn't put resin on it, or I didn't glass it to the bottom of the cabin top. So I'm gonna fill in some of the fiberglass at the front for the front mast, for the mast support. Won't be able to finish the mast support, and I don't have a long sleeve shirt today to do sanding, so I'm gonna do other things that don't involve sanding.
I'm getting a new microphone soon. Although this boat offers fantastic acoustics. Moving on. I'm gonna put some glass here, just to sort of fill it in, because there's a very high spot here, and I don't want to put a ton of filler in there just to fill that gap. So I'm gonna use fiberglass, same as before, not fancy. Just rip it apart, get the wisps on the edges. You can even pull this off a little bit here, so I'll do that. Then I'll just wet it out, put it on. Put it out again, put another layer on, and it's like just like paper mache from, you know, days of old. It's also easier if you wet out the fiberglass first. You don't have to. It just kind of starts breaking down the binders. Makes it a little bit easier to work with, and makes it easier to stick as well. Don't need a lot. You can wet the whole thing out for sure. Something like that. Not fancy. Without wetting it out fully, that's fully wet out. Much easier. Fin roller. We'll see how it works. It's coming up. So I've rolled out most of the air bubbles, some very small ones, but the roller's not spinning as well as it should. Probably throw it in acetone. But I'm gonna end up sanding sort of all of this down. So even though there's a hump, it's gonna sort of be flat. Then I'll just fill it in with filler, ferret, sand it, and gel coat it. That's pretty much what I'm gonna do. So this is the mast up. I'm gonna probably pull this off. Maybe bend it flat, reuse it. There's six screw holes in the step that going through the top of the cabin. So I'm gonna drill the holes today and see how it sits on the top. I'm probably gonna have to do some fairing and some cleaning up on the top just to make sure that it's sitting well. So I gotta be pretty careful.
how I drill the holes because there's fiberglass sitting on the top, and if you push too hard against a layer of fiberglass on the top, you could delaminate it. So, or at least like a little bit. Wouldn't delaminate the whole thing, but you'd give yourself a little extra work. So I'm using a very small drill bit, and which is a little bit smaller than the hole. Tip. Make sure you know what's on the other side of the thing you're drilling through. So I put the hatch cover on the top and couldn't see daylight, so kept drilling. Would have been drilling all day, pushing up against the bottom of that hatch cover. But it's moving now, I can see daylight, so that's good. We'll do the next one. And I'm actually going to sand a little bit of this. So this has I put resin in the holes. I did have to sand. Welcome to boating. Right roadside, on the top. And yeah. Kinda looks like shit. There's actually a low spot here. So I'm gonna have to fill that in. So I'll put this on top here. Line up a couple of holes. Good, still fits.
And
definitely a low spot here, a low spot here. So, gotta do some fairing. I may, just so that it sits on a nice, strong, flat surface, I may grind this down and fill it with some glass. Takes extra time. The glass is also right up to here. You can see it poking through. So this is like a high spot of the glass. So I think what I'll do is I'm gonna fair this, sand it down, and it probably won't need a lot. It might need eighth of an inch, maybe. So this is this amount, but the screw holes are sitting. Gonna have that feeling. Yeah, when I drilled that last hole, it went in sideways, so I think that hole might be have to be bigger. It's raining. Commence shutdown procedures.